Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. You know our next guest, because you just heard him, for being a renowned professor at Georgetown University, an opinion writer for the New York Times, and a riveting media personality. He needs no introduction, everybody. Please welcome Michael Eric Dyson.
Yeah. Yeah. Good to be back.
Yes.
We are always so happy to see you because you are a wealth of knowledge and you're so much fun.
Yes.
Thank you. I appreciate that. God. I appreciate it. Tell my kids that, man.
But you know, you always keep it real.
Yeah, I
and,
try to do that.
It's been some real things going on in
Lord
the White House.
Have mercy. Oh my
what
God.
What do you make of the impeachment proceedings?
Wow, it is the most vaunted public housing on earth, isn't it? In the White House. But you know, we have a man there who stands up every morning to excrete the feces of his moral depravity into a nation he has turned into his psychic commode. Here is a man who has desecrated the office. If Obama had had a white Russian drink in the White House, they'd have put him out, right? Now this man drinking with a white Russian.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
God,
who's making extraneous gas is just Putin every day.
Every day.
Come
every
on
day.
Now.
And
the thing is,
Putin.
Is
it's
that
just day. Watch
I'm just
word
I'm just
play.
You know
watch
I'm just trying to be slick with it. But, my point is that here's a guy who has, you know, the Republicans claim to uphold the values and principles of this nation and hold the line against fascists and those who would assault us. And now you're in bed with them?
Yeah.
You're in bed with them, making your progeny, your offspring, this illicit and ill-gotten gang called an American presidency of Donald Trump. Here's a guy who, from the very beginning, has worked against the best interests of this nation.
Yeah.
And now he has been impeached, but we know one thing. Now, Nancy Pelosi is a gangster. She understood what the process was, right? She understood how to orchestrate it and organize it. But we know the Senate under Mitch McConnell ain't gonna do nothing.
Yeah, that's
right.
The
that's the Stevie Wonder. You ain't done a thing. And so the reality is that they're going to try to justify and legitimate what this man is doing, and it is criminal. Here's the man who denied Obama his Supreme Court pick, and now he's turning it around, saying, "Oh my God, we got to get this done quickly." And, you know, expertly, and it is a ridiculous thing. The one great thing about having Donald Trump as president is that he has once and for all proved that the myth of white supremacy ain't nothing but a lie. Because ain't nothing supreme about that. You're inarticulate, you're proud to be unmolested by enlightenment, you know about 25 words, and you work them out, and you are almost preternaturally given to such ignorance that whatever comes out of your mouth is improvisational ignorance. And
Michael,
that's the thing he's doing.
And speaking of improvisation and wordsmith and playing it, extraneous Putin, that's a cold
line.
Did you catch it? I caught the tea, but I also caught this book.
Jay.
I pre-ordered this book when you first had it out because I just, I know that this, the collaboration of the two of you, your mind and his life is just, it's amazing.
I mean,
What was the reason? I mean, there are so many prolific MCs.
That's true.
What was the reason for Jay-Z? Why was Jay-Z your pick?
That's a great point, because there's so many. You got Rakim, you got Nas, you got Eminem.
Man.
You know, you got so many, you know, Lauryn Hill and Queen Latifah. But for me, Jay, first of all, he's turning 50. Mm-hmm. That's amazing. How did he get 50 and we just stayed the same age? I don't know. I have no idea. Then secondly, he's been in the game 30 years, and then thirdly, hip-hop is about 40 years. When you talk about above ground, 1979, well, a hip-hop, a hippity-doppity. So here it is, 40 years later. So now I said, this is a trio of anniversaries that we need to celebrate, and let me dig into what this dude is doing. Because a lot of people think he's clever, but they don't know how brilliant he is. How he's talked about politics. Bin Laden been happening in Manhattan. Crack was anthrax back then, back when police was Al-Qaeda to black man. What?
Yeah.
I mean, Or so I would write it if y'all could get it, but being intricate will get your wood critics on the internet. They like you should spit it. I'm like you should buy it. That's good business. So when you put together this man's lyrics,
you better sit and just listen to Jay-Z all day.
I mean, I do that too. But I mean, because he's worthy of that. Like
when
we got Robert Frost, whose woods these are, I think I know his house is in the village, though he will not see me stopping here to watch his woods fill up with snow. Right? God forgive me for my brash delivery, but I remember vividly what these streets did to me. I look at the poetic invention, the verbal imagination, the rhetorical sophistication, and when you throw in he's the first billionaire in hip-hop, and you throw in he's a great entrepreneur, and you throw in he's married to Beyonce.
His woman pick alone.
What did you learn?
Oh, my God. Right. You know, my spot. Come on, man.
Right, right. You know? What did you learn that you hadn't known about Jay-Z throughout this process?
Mm. You know what? The specificity of his metaphorical imagination. What I mean by that is that when you go listen to what he's doing, now, he ain't writing it down.
Right.
Just think about that.
Right.
Yeah. It's deep enough that you can read it and hear it, but he ain't even wrote it down.
Yeah.
As Richard Pryor said, no pen, no paper. Mm-hmm. Right? He ain't got nothing but his mind and imagination.
He mumbles. Mm.
And he mumbles right there. He sits there. You know, the mumble rappers, you know, it gives new meaning to them, right? Because the mumble rappers, you know,
well,
God bless them.
They don't come out with anything. Anything.
You know,
but go ahead.
That's their song. Yeah. His mumble is his start.
Come on.
That's his blueprint.
Man, my God. You see, that's their finish point. That's his beginning point.
Hello, somebody.
And I ain't trying to dog him, but that's what it is.
No, we love him. We love him here. Mm. But what did you think and how did you feel when you heard how people received him when he collaborated with the NFL?
Look, we gotta have inside game, outside game. You too young, but Starsky Hutch, Batman Robin. We need Steph Curry on the three-point line. We need LeBron on the inside. We gotta have people outside and inside.
Yes,
and
sure.
I know people thought he was giving up, but here's the point, that you need somebody out there. Jay-Z told them, we in the NFL stadiums too, we don't need you. So they heard the message. Mm-hmm. They were like, look, Jay said that, that's pressure. Mm-hmm. So when you bring pressure from the outside, then they invite you in, like Jesse Jackson, protest, Al Sharpton, protest. What do we do? Come inside and tell them what to do. Now, a lot of people think that he sold Colin out. He did not sell Colin Kaepernick out.
Yeah.
Colin Kaepernick is a beautiful, powerful, iconic figure. He needs to be celebrated. Jay-Z's doing what he's doing. Now, I think John Witherspoon could have gave my man some advice by saying, take that shirt off, right? And I ain't mad at him. Put on a Disney shirt, go up in there like Samson, and go inside and then kill the pillars from within because they let you in. I'm a light-skinned, curly-haired Negro with glasses. They think they got Martin Luther King Jr., and I give them Snoop Dogg when I get inside.
Come on. My God, today, Michael. Thank you so much for joining us.
Yes.
Always a joy. Be sure to pick up a copy of Michael's new book, Jay-Z Made in America, wherever fine books are sold. It's a great stocking stuffer when I tell you